I, Vandana Agarwal, feel privileged to introduce our chief guest, Mr. Rajeev Kher, CEO of Sarplast Private Limited and founder of 3S Shramik. Sir, passion for better sanitation led him to create India's very first portable sanitation and liquid waste management company back in the year 1999. Sir is one of India's 50 top social impact entrepreneurs who are making a difference to the lives of people in India. Request Rajeev, sir, to share his words of wisdom to the budding managers. Sir, the stage is all yours. Thank you.
Okay, first of all, thank you very much for such a warm welcome, Bala sir, and the students. I'm not an authority on management, or let me not say that I'm a management expert, but I run a fairly decent company, and I can only speak from my experiences which I have had in the past. The reason for me being here is not to give you a sermon or give you some kind of a lecture on management or what needs to be done by you. I think you know that best. But what I feel is that I think the most important thing is I feel that I can inspire you to probably create something on your own, probably do something which is innovative, do something which is really out of the box. Because that's something which I did. And today we run a successful company with about 500 employees. It's in about 10 states in India. We also have a couple of interests in foreign countries. And we are rapidly growing. We have private equity infusion from Swiss and Indian investors. And our valuation is somewhere close to about 175 crore. So in terms of... In terms of the space of work that we do, it's very unique, as they rightly mentioned and praised the work that we did, that we are this and this awards and all that. But let me tell you one thing, my friends here, that the most important thing that you need to really understand is to have focus. And that's something which from day one, I think I was quite committed in terms of what I was doing. I was very focused in my activity. A lot of people ask me, you know, that you are working in this space of sanitation and toilets and waste. It's not a very glamorous business to be in. It's not something which is on the wish list of many aspiring students here. And many of you might want to join an American Express or a Deloitte or an Ernst & Young or one of the big companies. But sanitation was, when I thought about it, I in fact had a job to work in Canada. And that's what I chucked and decided to come back and do over here. Was to run a successful company here. I never thought it would be that successful, very honestly. But I was very sure that I wanted to work in this space, I wanted to create impact, and I wanted to create a profitable model that would benefit people. Because at the end of the day, I always felt that the business that I do must reach out to the last mile, should reach out to people that will affect them in a very positive way and change their lives. Sanitation was one such activity. Only recently, I think in the last 3 years, our Honorable Prime Minister has taken up this drive of Swachh Bharat and decided to take up sanitation and toilets in a very big way. We thought about this almost 17 years ago. So we were already ahead of our plan. We were already well focused about what we wanted to do. In the journey, we learned a lot of things. And like I told you, a lot of people asked me, young students asked me, I was at ISB some time back, and somebody asked me that, you know, this is a great business today, you're successful. But what was your plan B? What if plan A had failed? What would be your plan B? My answer was, I have no plan B. I never had any plan B. I only had a plan A. Because the moment you have a plan B, the focus or the attention on plan A will get diluted. So we were very sure that we will only have a plan A and work diligently towards creating a successful business model out of this. I started this business in 99 actually, in 1999-2000. And we were a very, very small company until 2006 almost. And then we slowly started, when we got private equity from Avishkar, which is one of the largest venture management funds in the impact space, in 2010, we actually grew from 2010 onwards. So effectively at 2010 to 2016, I don't know how many percentage points we grew, but our valuation was about 10 crore in 2010, and we are at 175 crore in 2016, 2017. So these next few years in the college are going to be quite interesting, grueling. My only advice to you would be that focus on your work, focus on your studies. I'll tell you that the most important thing is academics, really. And the next 3-4 years is going to be, I think the next few years for you are going to be very, very crucial, because what you do now and what you study now, you're never going to get time to do that later on. These are the 2 years where you'll really be studying and working very hard to really become the real people that you're going to be. Don't be so focused about getting a job and, you know, constantly thinking, you know, everything is job centric and placement centric. Enjoy your time here, study well, become, you know, develop yourself overall. Let me tell you, getting a job or placement is not the end all and be all of everything. And I can assure you that I'm sure there will be sufficient amount of people here who would probably take up enterprise. And I remember that they had an enterprise cell here, some entrepreneurship cell or something like that. Was there something that that you guys were doing a while back? No, anyway. So, sir, what I would recommend is maybe an entrepreneurship cell should be started. I think a lot of colleges are doing that. Because I do agree that placements is absolutely prime and important. But at the same time, there could be some people who might want to do some business, who might want to do something that could be creative, could be innovative, and become probably more successful than many others who are going to join the rat race. So my suggestion would be that maybe an enterprise cell would be very useful. If there's any assistance that you need, I would be myself, I could let you know. If you need me, I'd be happy to help you. So. So I don't really need to blow my own trumpet. All I want to tell you is I'm happy to be here. The next 2 years are going to be great fun for you. We were also on the other side quite a few years ago. But it just feels like yesterday. In fact, when I meet Sampada and Bala sir, it really feels like yesterday. You know, this thing about that bus trip that we had, and it really takes me back to those days, and it feels like it was really yesterday. So. These days are, they never come back again. They're phenomenal 2 years of your life. So have fun, enjoy yourselves. Wish you all the very best for your placements, for your future endeavors. And if there's any assistance or help that you need from my side personally, I'm available for any kind of help. So thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for your kind words of wisdom.
I'm pleased to introduce our next guest, Ms. Sampada Vaze. She is a connoisseur of fashion industry and Indian media. She is an actor who has moved forward to shine and grab a major attention of audience through her skills of acting. Ma'am has taken her master's degree in human resource management from Symbiosis Institute of Management Studies and has worked with Arthur Ederson as an HR executive. Ma'am was also being awarded with the Symbiosis Sanskritik Puraskar by the Chief Minister of Maharashtra. She started her career as a model, turned towards acting, and has also appeared as a model in more than 150 commercial advertisements and outdoor billboards. For the prestigious brands like Coca-Cola, Sunsilk, amongst the many other brands. She has also hosted the popular show of Star News, Saas Bahu and Saajish, and was also being seen in some popular TV shows named Rishton Ki Door and Siya Ke Ram. Ma'am has made her acting debut in the Telugu film, in which she was hugely lauded by audience, and the film was ranked among the best films of the year 2002. Ma'am perfectly blends her management degree and experience in the corporate world with the creative business media. Now, I'll request Ms. Sampada Vaze ma'am to come enlighten us with her words.
First of all, I'm really happy to be here. I think Bala sir has been very, very instrumental in my professional career. So I'm going to tell you a little bit about my experiences with him as a director. It was a slightly different institute, but he's pretty much the same person. And what I chatted with the students when I was coming in about the tough regime, the kind of discipline you have, the presentations, etc., he hasn't changed, and I don't think the rigorous schedule has changed. So I'm hoping all of you will get as much out of it as I did. I'm going to tell you a little bit more about myself because I feel it's important for you to know everything so you can get as much as you can about various people. I believe successful people, irrespective of what field they are in, have certain things in common, whether it's focus or discipline or people skills. And while I did go on to do different things, I believe there's something we can learn from people, successful people, no matter what industry they're in. So that's where I'm coming from. Me and Rajeev, I was in HR. When I passed out, I was awarded the Lady Student of the Year award, and Sir is right. I was a day zero placement at Anderson. I worked there for 3 years in HR, where I handled all the human resource functions for business consulting and corporate finance. When I joined Bala Sir's Institute, I was like a really shy person who fought with my mother because I didn't want to do management. So she said, nahi, kar lo, iske baad fir tumhe jo bhi karna hai, you can do. So when I came here, the first thing it started off with was you have to give a presentation in front of, that time our batch was 250, 300 people. And I used to get panic attacks. I could barely talk in front of 10 people. I was like, how am I going to talk in front of 300 people? And now I hear you guys are 1,000 in your batch. Is that correct? Yeah, and you all have to present in front of 1,000 people when you don't know anyone, correct? Yeah, so that's a pretty scary thought, I'm assuming. So it was literally a trial by fire with Bala sir. He's like, you know, you like it, there's no other option. There's no falling sick, there's nothing. We used to have, I can see a lot of colorful saris here. I'm feeling really jealous because we were only allowed to wear navy blue saris, which we wore all the time. And in fact, half the people from our batch are so sick of the color, we'll never wear the color navy blue again because for us, we wore it for 2 years in a row. We were allowed 2 holidays in a year. We had a nine month internship where we had six months part time, where we had to work from 9 to 2, and from 3:30 to 8:30 we had lectures, and we still had assignments. And on Sunday we had the luxury of starting work at 2:30, and we had a 90% attendance. Otherwise, you know, you can't give your exams. And when I heard in the car that you're supposed to watch Mahabharata, I was like, sir has really become soft in his old age. Hame to kuch nahi dikhaya usne. He was never so nice to us. So my point is that all this discipline, this, all the things we cribbed, we complained about, it's really formed, at least for me, it's formed the core of my professional life, no matter what I did. So when you're working 16 hours a day and you only have to work 12 hours a day, you're like, this is a really easy life. You know, all the things he taught us, that okay, what's important, discipline is important, teamwork is important. He made sure you worked in a team, whether you liked the people or not. He was very, very driven. He set such high standards. That's kind of helped me no matter what I did. I also want to talk about the fact that I'm not just an actress. So I hope my management experience has helped me transition to other fields. So apart from the fact that I've done the lead roles in a couple of television shows and movies and things like that, I also was invited by the Indian Embassy. I anchored the International Yoga Day in Thailand. There were 7,500 people, which is the largest gathering outside the one in New Delhi. I write a popular blog. I've been published a 6-page article in a magazine, and I'm also turning a producer this year. So So I like to believe that all of this would not have happened with my rock solid fundamentals that I learned in my management. And I know it's a big drag, and some of you believe ki acha MBA ka chhap chahiye ya degree chahiye, whatever it is. I don't know what you all came in with, but I'd like you to take as much as you can, because trust me, these years will be formative. The friendships you make will last you forever. You guys will be meeting 10, 15 years down the line like we do, and you'll be like, you remember this happened, and oh my God, you were so sick, tum marte marte exam ke liye aaye the. These memories, these friendships, the fundamentals you learn will last you throughout your life. So try and get as much out of it as you can. Trust me, it'll only help you no matter what your choice of career is. And both me and Rajeev wanted to make this an interactive session rather than us preaching to you, because we don't believe we're in any position to preach. So we'd like you to be as open as you can with your questions. Feel free to ask. Both Rajeev and I have followed slightly different tracks, but like I said, there's something to learn from successful people no matter what industry they're in or what career path they chose. So keep that in mind, ask us questions. And I must say, you're very lucky to have Bala sir there. It was a trial by fire. We were petrified of him, but everything he taught us has remained with us till date. So all the very best to you, and thank you very much for having us here.
For an entrepreneur, the toughest thing is to start, to take the risk and get the investments done. How did you start, and what was the point when you felt successful? For you, sir.
The first time when I actually went to a bank to get a loan, it was for 3 lakh rupees. And the banker saw, you know, what we learn here, again, was presentation skills, I think, in what Bala sir teaches, is unmatched, unparalleled to anywhere in the country. So that is something which I can carry off. So if you ask me to do a presentation, that time we used to do presentations on this OHP, overhead projector, with the, you know, this transparency and write. And my handwriting was horrible. I don't know how many slides I must have made Sampada do at that time. And, you know, we used to use those OHPs. But we were so good at presentation skills that was the first time I used my presentation skills with a banker, what I had learned here. And for a 3 lakh rupee loan. And he saw my proposal, very well made business plan, presentation was super. But he started laughing at me. He says, "Yeah, India mein toilet kon lega? Sab to bahar hi jaate hain." And this is, I'm talking about 18 years ago. So that time it was quite a setback for me. So I had to go out and take a loan from a NBFC at about, if I'm not mistaken, it was 23% at that time. Yeah, 23% interest for 3 lakh rupees. And, you know, I took this loan and I built up on that 3 lakh rupees. I had started from a 5,000 rupee investment, added 3 lakh rupees maybe subsequently, and then steadily grew the company. But there have been enough number of times where I've been sort of pretty much kicked out of the door by saying, you know, we can't give you a loan or we can't give you funding. It's only when we got to a certain level to prove ourselves that we had the potential to become a great big company, and private equity companies were interested in investing with us. So 2010, when we got our first infusion, we grew at something like 300% annually subsequent to that. And like I said, that now we've reached a certain stage where we almost have a considerable market share in the country. But yeah, I mean, being an entrepreneur is not easy. You always have to have that first time when they say no to you. And that's what gives you even more vitality, gives you even more spirit to really go and achieve something more.
Hello, sir. Hello, ma'am. Ma'am, last corner. Ma'am, my question is for you. I would like to ask you that you have been worked in corporate culture, that hectic schedule, you have managed all that, right? So I would like to ask you that what are the similarities or differences you face nowadays, that corporate culture and now your schedule and your day-to-day life?
What's the difference, you mean?
Difference or similarities whatsoever?
Well, to be honest with you, corporate life was much easier. It was much easier. A normal shooting day is 12 hours a day. And to give you a little bit tidbit about the television industry, when you are part of a show which is on air 5 days a week, that's about 20 to 23, 24 days a month, right? There are a lot of advertising revenue riding on you, especially if you're playing a leading role. So the show must go on. So I have shot with 103 degree fever. The producer told me, ki haan, chehre pe nahi dekhega, haan, manage kar lenge. I've shot with a fractured hand. I've shot with chicken pox because it hadn't come to my face and it was all over my body. So it is 10 times tougher, honestly. So people who think, oh, we have a cushy life. No, we don't have a cushy life. We work really hard. I've got up at 3 in the morning to drive for 2 hours to reach a location because the director wants to shoot in the morning light between, let's say, 5 and 7 o'clock in the morning. So anyone who you see who's successful, no one has it easy. Our life just looks really good, but we work really hard. And to be honest with you, I find corporate life a bit easier. And to be blunt with you, I'll tell you our value declines as we grow older, honestly. Whereas in corporate life, your value increases the more experience you have. We have a shelf life of 10 years, 15 years. Maybe some people are just 5-6 years. So we have to cram in a 20-30 year of work life into that time. So we work double shifts. I've shot in Hyderabad in the morning, in Chennai in the evening, and only slept on flights. And there are people who have much worse schedules than I do. So it's tougher. So corporate life is the easier part, honestly.
Thank you. Thank you so much, ma'am. It was a session of deep insight which will surely help us in our professional journey and more importantly our session through life, success through life. I also thank our beloved Bala sir for giving us an opportunity to learn from Stalwart and organizing such guest lecture for our budding student managers. Sir, ma'am, we promise to make the most of such interactions. I also thank the faculty and staff of Sri Balaji Society for their support and guidance. Thank you. Thank you.